Hey everybody, and welcome to Formal Logic. What I want to do today is to go over some of the basic symbolization aspects of Formal Logic. So this is the part that will be the formal part of Formal Logic. Now logic, again, is the study of correct and incorrect reasoning. What Formal Logic allows us to do is actually to simplify things down in ways that make it easy for us to analyze. So what we're going to be doing in this class, even though it's introduction to formal logic, it's actually introduction to propositional logic. What is propositional logic? Propositional logic is where we're going to make a single letter stand for a simple statement. Which brings me to this. What are simple statements? As opposed to what are called complex or compound statements. Well, again, what's a statement? A statement is any kind of utterance that is something we can say out loud or something that we can write down that has truth value to it. It can be true or false. So already on some of the sways up on Blackboard, you should have seen that there are some kinds of things that we can say and write down that are not statements. I think the most obvious one is questions. Questions are not statements. So like, what day is it? Is neither true nor false. Saying today is Wednesday could be true or false depending on what day of the week that it falls on. So questions are not statements. Imperatives, go to your room. Not true or false. Also proposals, hey, let's go see a movie. Not statements. Therefore, they have no truth value. And then also, there's a fourth category we can call gibberish. Some other analytic philosophers would say that there are additional categories that have no truth value. Everything from I love you, that's gibberish, to God exists. Some would say that. Now, for our purposes, statements are something that have a truth value. And basically, they are subject-verb-predicate relations. What do I mean by that, subject-verb-predicate? Well, if you've ever studied any kind of either English or any other foreign language and you've studied it, you'll at least be familiar with the terms subject, verb, predicate. So in our case, I am Professor Burns. I, subject, am, verb, Professor Burns. That tells you something about the subject by means of the verb. This is simple statement. Now you can have simple statements that are actually lengthier than this. That's not the point. The point that I want to say is that when we render simple statements in here, the way that I'm going to represent this, this is a proposition. I am Professor Burris. When I say it, it does happen to be true. So it has, there's a, now if I'm not a professor or I, you know, go through some kind of identity crisis or I, you know, get a, someone else inhabits my body or something like that, then I'm no longer Professor Burris, so this could be false. But this is a propositional statement. Now what we're going to do is we're going to want to represent it formally. Here's what I'm going to do on the board. I am just going to arbitrarily, it's going to be entirely arbitrarily, underline any word. There you go. I am Professor Burris. It's not that the accent is on the word professor in this case. What I'm going to do with this is when we have any simple statement on the board, I'm going to underline, and I'm just picking one. Doesn't matter, doesn't need to be the subject, doesn't need to be the verb, doesn't need to be the predicate. I'm just gonna pick one of the words in that proposition, one of the words in that sentence, I'm gonna underline it. And then what you will do, or the way that we're going to represent it, is we'll take the first letter of that underlined word to stand for the whole statement. Not the word, but the statement. So in other words, or in short, take a look at this, I, Professor Burris. The underlined word here happens to be professor. It starts with P. So the way that I'm going to simplify this formally is I'm going to say, instead of saying, I am Professor Burris, I'm going to say, this is the same thing as saying P. Now P does not stand for professor. P stands for I am Professor Burris. Now if I want to, instead of going by way of the P, I am Professor Burris, I'm just arbitrarily deciding to render it with the B instead. I can totally do that, that's fine, so can you. But this is a simple statement, subject, verb, predicate, any kind of simple statement will basically boil down to one letter of representation. Now, there are additional ways to represent things in formal logic other than simple propositional logic. There's predicate logic, mode logic. This is intro to formal logic. We're not doing any of that in Helium, propositional logic. So we've got our simple statements, which are always going to be one letter. Just one letter is standing for a simple true or false kind of statement. But then we have complex or compound statements. Here's two separate statements. Okay, we've already established that P is, I'm making it stand for, I am present for us. Also, on the day of this recording, it happens to be a Wednesday. So here's a simple one. Today is Wednesday. And I'm just arbitrarily deciding to underline this. What this will mean is that I'm saying here, today is Wednesday, how are we going to represent that? W. So now here's two simple statements. P, I've already said, stands for I'm Professor Earth. W stands for today's Wednesday. And these are two simple statements floating out there in isolation. But what if I wanted to throw them together? Because we don't live life and we don't talk with simply just simple statements. Today is Wednesday. I'm Professor Burritt. We mix all these kinds of things together, but we do so in different ways. So what if I wanted to say something simple like, well, technically not simple, but I am Professor Burris and today is Wednesday. Could I do that? Yes. Is that a simple statement? Nope. Now that is complex or compound because there's a bringing together of at least two simple statements. You get at least two together, you've got a compound or complex statement. So if I said something like, today is Wednesday, or I am Professor Burris, and today is Wednesday. It's no longer complex, but compound. And logic gives us symbols for how to connect things together. Propositional logic. Now, these are propositional logic symbols, but they extend to all the more advanced kinds of logic. What are these symbols? Well, that's what I'm going to do in our next little video, is go into what the symbols for formal logic are and what they stand for.